Nơi tôi đang đứng đây, thành phố biển Quy Nhơn xinh đẹp, rộn ràng trong không khí náo nhiệt những ngày đầu xuân Tân Sửu năm 2021. Thành phố biển Quy Nhơn cũng như Bình Định không chỉ nổi tiếng bởi những bãi biển dài đẹp và cát trắng vàng xanh, mà cũng như các bạn đã biết, Bình Định là cái nôi của bóng đá miền Trung trong khoảng 20 năm trở về trước. Bóng đá Bình Định có những cổ động viên rất cuồng nhiệt. Và hôm nay, Hội Cổ động viên bóng đá Bình Định chúng tôi xin gửi đến các bạn một lời chúc sức khỏe đầu năm. Và chúng ta hôm nay sẽ được gặp một nhân vật rất đặc biệt trong những ngày đầu năm mới. Hãy cùng chúng tôi tìm hiểu, gặp anh ấy tại thành phố biển Quy Nhơn hôm nay.
Hello Danny, I'm very happy to see you. Welcome to Quy Nhơn City. Let's we back an interview.
Yes.
Yes. The first, please tell us a little about the current your projects and you are implement in Quy Nhơn City project.
Yes. We opened like 2 weeks ago. The CEO of Quy Nhơn, the center. And she asked me to join with her group friends to join in the CEO pub. And so far it's very funny, it's very nice project. We have many people who coming to visit the pub. Very nice atmosphere. Next to we have also the karaoke. It's quite, you know, in Europe,
yes.
we don't have really the karaoke culture. It's really Asian, but very beautiful with a group of friends, drinking, singing, and it's really nice atmosphere. So we have the CEO pub and the karaoke, and very beautiful, very nice.
Potential areas worldwide. I think
which Quy Nhơn City, what impression did you have, and how is your life in Vietnam nowadays?
Right now, we're living in Ho Chi Minh. I fell in love immediately with Quy Nhơn. It's a beautiful city. To be honest, after 2 months, I will stay for 10 years in Vietnam. And I visit many cities, Haiphong, Hanoi, Da Nang, all around Vietnam.
Thanh Hoa.
Thanh Hoa. I lived for 5 years in Thanh Hoa. But I was never in Quy Nhơn. So 2 weeks ago, for me, it was the first time I visit Quy Nhơn. But beautiful, beautiful. It's even right now that I talk with my wife. We want to look for some land and to live in Quy Nhơn. We love it. It's the beach, it's the people, very beautiful people. Everybody's friendly, very honest. Also the center, many flowers. There's a big. I think the government here do really for family feeling. For the there's many activity for kids. The seafood.
That is amazing for you.
Amazing.
Yes.
Amazing. I love it. I love it.
Where you are sitting here, Quy Nhơn City.
Yeah.
Bình Định football has returned to village after more than 12 years.
Yes.
Yes. In your opinion, what should you do, Bình Định football, do to build professional football in several years?
Yes, it's you can say Bình Định FC is for 12 years not in the village.
Yeah.
I'm 10 years ago.
Yes. Yes. I know.
So I never.
Never missed the Bình Định.
Yes, yes, yes. So, but I hear for the fans, they really love football. No, I don't play for Chennai. But yeah. Those clubs, the province clubs, they have a very strong connection with the fans.
Yes.
The fans love the club, and I think in Bình Định also. What I see in Vietnamese football, also with Dong Nai, I think the club have to working a lot with the new generation, with the new generation, the kids from Bình Định, to get the kids get the feeling together with the club, but also I think bring many companies to the football. What I see in my former years in football Vietnam, sometimes the club depends on one sponsor or on one boss. Like in Dong Nai, before we have a boss, he really loved football. But yeah. After he changed the boss, the new boss don't like football so much,
yeah.
And then the club go down.
And I think for Finland, it's very good to reach many sponsors to jump in. That you have maybe 50 kind of sponsors who invest in the football.
What I don't see in Vietnam so far is like the business launch. If you make a business launch, so many companies will want to invest for money in football. They can network and bring many money to the football club. It's something that a strong fundamental for every club.
Yes. When the player, football player, are playing on beautiful grass and high quality field.
Yes, I think that's very important. It's very important for everybody because the better the grass, the better the players can play football. It's also that the fans can watch better football. But also, I think for the new generation, for the kids, if they're training on good facilities, it will improve their quality also.
With a name, but they stay maybe 1 year.
Yes.
After 1 year, they leave and they lose the money.
No reason.
For no reason. I think this kind of money you can invest also in the children, in the youth academy, because the youth academy, this is the future for Vietnamese football and also for Vietnam.
Danny, bạn hãy gửi một cái lời chào đầu năm mới tới toàn thể cổ động viên bóng đá Bình Định.
Xin chào, cổ động viên bóng đá Bình Định. Chúc đội bóng Bình Định thi đấu thành công năm 2021.